In 1847, immigrants from Glasgow, Scotland, arrived in New Zealand's South Island to establish a settlement at the head of the Otago Harbour. They called it Dunedin. Fed by the Otago gold rush of the 1860s, Dunedin became New Zealand's largest city, attracting many Chinese immigrants whose families remain today. In the early 1900s, construction started on the stunning railway station, now considered to be the most photographed building in all of New Zealand. But for motorsport fans, the true treasure of Dunedin are the fantastic Otago roads. These highways of rally attract competitors from around the globe to compete in the Otago Classic Rally. And alongside the classics come the cars and drivers of the Brian Green Property Group New Zealand Rally Championship. Ken Block returns after taking victory at round one in Whangarei. But with the American not eligible for points, it's Ben Hunt from Auckland who took maximum points. Hunt leads with 42 and Matt Summerfield, the big surprise, in second place. Round two is in Dunedin, home to one of our leading competitors, Emma Gilmore.
Hi everyone and welcome to Dunedin, my home rally Otago. Really looking forward to this event this year. The stages, there's some new ones that we haven't seen before, definitely a bit of a mix. We always seem to go well down here. I like the fast roads and the mix of the forestry as well. The Wii Suzuki Swift Maxi has been going really well. And hopefully we can keep building on its feet, keep improving and have a good result here.
We're here with Jack the Bear, the Stadium Finance mascot. Unbelievably tall, about the only person I remember that tall was David Holder. So maybe he's got a different gig this weekend while he gets the car fixed from Whangarei.
Hidden, five left minus.
This is what happens when you fail at rally driving. The boss tells you to do this.
Mate, you didn't fail. Far from it, buddy. We'll see you next time.
Sounds good.
Well, the new fast man of the NZRC, Ben Hunt, he really took it to Ken Block with stage times at Whangarei. This rally, it might suit his car just a little bit more. So how do you think the stages will go, Ben?
Yeah, you know, we've had a good look at all the stages over the last few days with Ricky and I just drove the car for the first time half an hour ago and yeah, she's definitely got a lot more boogie than what we had in Whangarei, so hopefully we'll be able to take it to Ken Block a bit more than we did up there.
And we know that your car is nowhere near the spec. That Ken's car, full World Rally Championship spec car, but the nature of these roads, they're really fast, require huge commitment, and do you think a little bit more knowledge of the roads will be a help?
Yeah, well, I think Ken's probably a little bit disadvantaged here this weekend with, you know, he's done mainly WRC events and two-pass Ricky and that, so I think a bit of knowledge from our part, with the roads, we should suit us a bit better.
And hoping to build on his start at number three, Matt Summerfield.
First and foremost is to come down here and get points. We really have to finish every round this year. I think if you finish every round, you'll be in with a shot of the title. So, yeah, definitely finish this one and then probably be hard not to have a nudge at Canterbury.
And making a welcome return to the championship, WRC star Hayden Paddon.
Yeah, this is a one event we like to do every year and come here and do the Classic Rally. And we obviously have a bit of unfinished business as well, but you know, being able to drive a classic BDA that's twice my age and get to go sideways, you know, is a lot of fun.
The championship drivers have made the decision on start order, but leading the field and heading away from the start first up will be the head hoonigan himself, Ken Block, in his Fiesta Hybrid Function Hoon vehicle, or Fiesta HFHV for short. So let's check out the stages with our B&T stage preview. Based in Dunedin, the rally will travel north for day one and south for day two. Stage one and five are 23 k's of rough forest through the Wainakarua stage. Two and six Razorback, faster and shorter at 12 k. Back on public roads for stage three and an 8 k sprint at Shag Valley. Stage seven, Goodwood, is another short sprint with the tarmac at the end. Then it's back to the forest and Silver Peaks before the spectator stage around the Dunedin streets.
Hi, I'm Ken Block. It is very early morning here in Dunedin, and I'm here for round two, Rally Otago. So this rally's quite a bit different than the rally up in Whangarei. It's going to be quite a bigger challenge. I'm hoping that we made some good changes to the notes, and we're able to get out there and drive pretty quick this morning. But we'll see if we are able to repeat what we were able to do up in Whangarei.
Still clear conditions for stage one, 23 kilometres, but no wind means could get a bit dusty later on, Glenn.
Yeah, with no wind to blow the dust away, 1 minute's not a lot of time between cars. It'll be okay, certainly for Ken Block, maybe for Ben Hunt, but as the cars get through the stages, it'll just linger around and later runners can start to have some problems.
17 minutes 29.3 for Block. Ben Hunt starting 1 minute behind. Definitely some dust in the air there.
Yeah, as you can see, it just starts to linger, so Ben's going to add to the dust that is still there from Ken Block. The next car's on the road, it's just going to compound, gets a little bit nasty when you can't see where you're going. And Ben is catching some dust there.
Great time for Hunt though, 17 minutes 05.9, 23 seconds faster than Block. Matt Summerfield should have good road conditions now, especially now the top two have swept the gravel off the surface of the road.
Forestry stages, they're used to trucks, very, very hard base. The first couple of cars sweep it away and leave a cleaner line to get more grip, more traction and a faster stage time.
Summerfield slow to the stage end with an overheating engine though. Phil Campbell, another of the young drivers in the championship, this his second season running the Evo 9.
This car is still really a Group N type car. Phil's going to have a hard job beating Ben, but he's shown he can be very consistent and he really is driving with his head.
32 seconds down on Hunt here. Dylan Turner a further 10 seconds back in his Evo 9 as the dust really starts to hang in the air. Alex Kelsey in his MC2 rally special, but dust really hampering him now and he crashed out of the 9K mark. A slow start for Graham Featherston, over a minute off Hunt's pace. And that meant Emma Gilmore was in his dust. She hit a tree, but still managed 17 minutes 44, fifth fastest so far. Andrew Hawkswood, suffering from a misfire on his engine, would be only 10th fastest. But a good start for Lance Williams. Despite running 10th on the road, he posted fifth fastest time. At stage end, Emma Gilmore finding that the crash had damaged a gearbox cooler and hoping that she could get through the stages to service. Stage 2 Razorback, 11.85 kilometres. Still a forest stage, but really quite different in places to stage 1.
And these roads have a lot more day-to-day traffic on them, so they're already looking a lot cleaner than stage 1.
Block 7 minutes 02.6. Hunt had picked up a 10-second penalty after bleeding his brakes before the stage start and arrived late to control, but it was worth his while when he needed all of his brakes right here.
And that is as close as you'll see to going over without crashing.
Six left, 60.
Another good stage for Lance Williams, keeping him in the top five.
And Lance is really enjoying his rally, trying to take the pressure off. Crunch Bennett does a great job controlling him. He wants to be good because he's not the lightest co-driver.
Phil Campbell now 8.4 seconds down on Williams. But a big improvement for Matt Summerfield, third fastest on the stage, just 7 seconds behind Hunt, but carrying a 1 minute penalty after stopping to top up the radiator before the stage. Andrew Hawkswood making some progress, moving up to eighth.
30. Six right, tight as long, five plus.
But this stage would see problems for two-wheel drive championship leader Max Bailey. Emma Gilmore had started the stage late, picking up 2 minutes and penalties, so she was running behind Bailey. But aside from his dust, she had bigger problems. Emma finally passing Bailey as he crawled out of the stage, but she would retire at the stage end. Stage 3, Shag Valley, and we're back on public roads for the 8K sprint. And here we go, Glenn, with Ken Block.
Yeah, the public roads in general are a little bit wider, more camber. Drivers really get into them.
Ben Hunt still holding the lead, but now was under 9 seconds. Lance William third, but 36 seconds down on Hunt. Phil Campbell another 8 seconds back, with Summerfield out with engine issues.
Five right minus. Six left minus 50. Flat mid crest.
And a big improvement here for Shannon Chambers. Six his stage time's 50. Now closer to Dylan Turner.
Flat mid crest.
The Gold Class 5 Challenge for older cars saw Daniel Walker in the lead and in seventh outright. After 2014 winner Darren Galbraith had retired on stage one. Richard Bateman then second, returning after a bad crash at round one. Tyler Radovan had been second, but had turbo boost issues and dropped to third. Hugh Spence fourth in his tidy Impreza, and Jonathan Shapley fifth in his older Evo 4. But in the B&T Classics, Hayden Patton not only led, but had the Escort BDA up to fourth overall by the stage end. Former New Zealand champ Brian Stokes was second, but a minute and a half back. Marcus Van Klink struggling through the stages after brake issues.
Here's two left, here's two left.
Yep.
How's your pedal?
I'm nursing it.
Yeah, five right, 120.
Andy Martin, though, keeping him honest with the RX3 just 9 seconds behind. And rally sponsor Tony Gosling, fifth in a slightly underpowered Escort Mark 1. Stage 4 would see problems for Ben Hunt, who punctured, and Ken Block, who stopped. Hayden Patton actually winning the stage and now led the rally outright.
5 left minus cut. 150. Five right opens. 150.
So heading to the first servant, it's Patton, 19 seconds clear of Campbell, with Williams third. Brian Stokes second to Storick in fifth, but it's been a tough morning for the Class 1 contenders.
Ben, a lot of carnage this morning. Your car doesn't look exactly right.
Yeah, no, we've had a slight mishap. Now we've really got an issue. We got a flatty 11K from the end of that stage, and it was on the front, so we jumped out to change it, as you do. The new wheels that we just brought don't fit. So we had to front to rear the right-hand side and, yeah, cruise out.
This morning you started third on the road, but now you're running first. Is that making a difference to how you attack the corners?
With Ken stopping in that stage and Ben getting the puncher, we were there just by ourselves, having no lines to follow. It's definitely a different experience, but it's good fun. Go where we want to go.
Max, you got back to the service not quite the way you wanted.
No, we came back a bit early in stage two, about 3Ks from the end. We hit a rock in the middle of the road and that catapulted us into a bank, so we've withdrawn for the weekend. We just want to get it back and see how much damage there really is.
And a familiar problem for Andrew Hawkswood.
Basically the same problem as we had up in Whangarei, but it's shifted to a different cylinder, so it does make it tricky to actually isolate what the issue is.
And it's been a hectic few weeks for Richard Bateman, who crashed heavily in Whangarei.
Massive 2 weeks. The guys at home just pulled out of the stops and late nights and got it all together for us.
The Otago Classic Rally is world renowned and has attracted many former world champions over the years. In 2015, Alistair McRae and Hayden Patton were doing battle in Escort BDAs alongside the historic class entry of former New Zealand champ Brian Stokes.
Oh yeah, we're having fun, you know. We've been working with this car for a wee bit now and I think we're sort of finally getting to a point where it's going how I'd like it to go.
But it's not just the Ford fans. Marcus Van Klink leads the Roto Brigade in his Group B RX7.
It was always good to see a variety of cars out here, so yeah, no, we'll give it to them this afternoon, see if we can get some time back.
And the car might be old, but still plenty of fans out to see Andy Martin's RX3.
Clearly, I think older the cars, the more people like them, and everywhere we go, we get lots of praise. So she's a good old girl, and we've got it going well this weekend.
It's just fun. I think if you walk around the service bike, everybody's having fun, and that's what this rally's about, and that's why we try and become a part of it as much as we can.
Stage 5, a repeat of Stage 1, and Ben Hunt trying hard to claw back the 13 positions he lost. He took 48 seconds of his morning stage time.
Cut 4 left, plus
still loose in the rear, right?
Yeah, short six right, keep in six left minus 30, keep in six right plus 60.
Phil Campbell second on the stage, but 22 seconds slower. So would that be enough to take back the lead?
Right. Five right minus, five left. Six right, 30 to three right.
Lance Williams holding on to third, but only improving his stage time by 15 seconds.
That's good. I like that.
The stage was never going to suit the two-wheel drive Escort. Patton, 47 seconds slower than Hunt, but also slower than Campbell, so slipped back to second.
That's still pretty committed though, isn't it? In these tight and twisty stuffs, that's where the traction disadvantage is going to be at its greatest, and that's why he's lost some time.
K120. Very long, five left minus Titans, three plus.
Brian Stokes also losing time, but holding on to fifth. He was under pressure from Graham Featherston, who moved up four places to close it on the Escort. Brian Green dropping a position, but just 2 seconds behind Featherston. Stage six, Razorback two, and Ben Hunt won the stage again, now moving up to fifth overall and looking like he might get back to the top three. Phil Campbell avoiding rocks on his way to third fastest stage time and still holding the lead.
Long five left minus 30. Long five right, blip, caution, three right.
That's what you do see in a forestry stage. There can be some massive rocks. Trying to avoid them is a key.
Big moment for Lance Williams, but luck on his side, and he still holds on to third place.
Good. 156 left minus.
Holy shit, that try just then.
Dylan Turner now fourth, just under 20 seconds away from Williams. Patton not able to match Hunt here, but again he beat Campbell and closed to 3.3 seconds in second place. But end of the day for Brian Stokes, who rolled his Escort on the stage and out of fifth place. So Van Clink moves to second historic, despite still having brake issues.
Careful. Yeah, sorry, I've got
30 and 6 left. And 60 and long 5 left minus here, Marcus.
Yep, just okay, yep.
600 to go. Long 5 right minus, opening tightening long 4.
Andy Martin had replaced a windscreen in service but got going again in third. Tony Gosling lost a lot of time changing a puncher, then the car's distributor packed up. So stage 7 Goodwood, a short sprint but with tarmac.
And it's important not to attack too hard on that tarmac. They've got a long stage coming up and they don't want to blaze the tyres.
Flat 6 right, opens 50.
Campbell just 4.3 seconds down on Hunt on the stage, but it was Patton he had to worry about. Lance Williams 1.3 seconds back. Turner throwing everything at the stage in fourth position. It's been a good day though for the Mitsubishi driver. Six from Graham Featherston after day one spent in other people's dust, so happy to be back on tarmac. Brian Green also improving to seventh, and Shannon Chambers improving to eighth place. Dave Strong having a miserable rally though after discovering his engine was 20% down on power. Hayden Padden only 8th fastest on stage 7, still holding on to 2nd place but now 11.6 down on Campbell. But Padden did make up time in the next stage, so just the super special to run, Campbell has a lead of just 0.3. And the spectators were out in force to see the car slide around the Old Port roads. A spin by Hayden Padden put paid to a victory on day one, but the man they'd all come to see didn't disappoint. Yes, the king of the Gymkhana, Ken Block, returning to the rally after repairing his car and winding up the Fiesta HFHV to a stage win. So Phil Campbell takes the day one win and the points, while Hayden Paddon is second but leads both the Otago Classic Rally and the B&T Historic Class. And in the Gold Class 5 Challenge, Richard Bateman takes the win over Hugh Spence and Jonathan Shepard.
It was just a matter of keeping the nose clean all day, and yeah, it just happened at the end, so we're quite lucky really.
3 days into the National Championship, you're really starting to get some very good points.
I don't want to go out and do anything silly and not get any points, so tomorrow we'll just be doing the same again and drive down the middle of the road and make sure we make it to the end and get a decent haul of points for the weekend.
Fair bit of work on the car going now.
Yeah, we just had a rear diff problem for the last two or three stages, so we've just had to take it a little bit easy on gear changes and things, and nothing too serious. We'll get it fixed now and be back out there tomorrow.
Sunday morning, another perfect day, and Ken Block back and ready to take on the stages.
Very small part just ruined a very big effort to come out here and have a good result, but that's racing, it is what it is, and you know, it's just a very small race part, you know, basically an RPM sensor. So we were able to fix the car just out on the stage, wasn't that difficult once the crew got there with the right parts, and we're able to continue on and come back into town. But the good thing is we get to go out today and race all day.
Ben, you've told us this morning you're going to put on a real charge. Might there be a problem with dust?
Yeah, there possibly could be. That some of these stages today were really dusty, and thankfully the organisers have seated us at number two, although we did finish fifth last night. So I guess, yeah, that's a good thing, and there will be a little bit of extra gravel to sweep out of the way, but you know, I don't mind doing that, so really looking forward to getting out there.
So let's see what's in store with the B&T stage preview. Seven stages today, starting at Fuddy Flat, a mix of forest and public roads. Then stage 11, Big Stone, up and over the coast hills, including tarmac. After service, it's up the Waipori Gorge, then back down through Berwick Forest. Another service, then three stages, finishing with the power stage and the awesome Koori Bush. So stage 10, Fuddy Flat, a longer version this year, starting with the stage normally finished. Block will run first on the road again. Ben Hunt with a similar mission, win the day and try to get back into the top three overall.
And he really has had some stunning pace. He'll be on a charge this morning, try and get a good lot of time back.
But that arrow says he should go left.
There you go. And over the rock.
Couldn't see because of the dust.
And here's another puncher. It may have been that rock or another rock, but either way, they're going to get real used to changing spare tyres. At least it'll fit today.
Phil Campbell can make big strides in the points if he extends his day one lead today, though.
Yeah, it's a bit of a tough mission. He's got to keep doing what he's doing because it's working. But, of course, keep an eye on who's coming from behind. Ben Hutt's going fast. Hayden Paddon will go fast.
Good to see Lance Williams starting, but there's a question about the engine.
They've had ongoing overheating issues. They don't want to wreck an engine with Canterbury just around the corner. They'll just have to see how it goes today. But with the sun strike, it's a tricky stage anyway. He really has to put the engine problems out of his mind, concentrate on the job at hand. That's not easy.
Dylan Turner had a spin on the stage, losing 15 seconds. Alex Kelsey back, hoping to get some sort of stage miles completed, but again he would strike problems. Matt Summerfield had spent Saturday repairing his engine, back now to try and get some points again.
Some good bonus points for the day, and of course the power stage as well for bonus points. There you can see Alex off in the bank there. He just needs to catch some luck.
Coming down the hill and when you sort of brake and the engine locks up as you're braking and then it just wouldn't restart. And I had to throw it this way to try and stop it.
Andrew Hawkswood was also back, hoping his engine misfire had finally gone. Not as bad as day one, but still sounds a bit sick. Graham Featherston learning with a new co-driver this year and those tricky Otago stages.
Nothing
but
all.
A short day for Shannon Chambers, no brakes at the stage end. Hayden Patton, of course, starting at the head of the classic field. Buck continuing his form as he entertains the crowd on his way to second place. 200. Stage 11 Big Stone, used as part of the Currie Bush Road. Seems like Ken Block was keen to take some of the bush home, eventually losing the extra baggage and heading to the service in the lead. A huge task now for Ben Hunt to make up 3.5 minutes over six stages.
Yeah, he's certainly quick, but that second punch from the rally is really going to hamper him. But he'll keep pushing on.
Finish, crest 250. Keep in five right over, finish crest 250.
Stage time 11 minutes 02.9. That would win the stage, but he was still 13th. Matt Summerfield, second fastest, making up time after a half spin on stage one. But he was second fastest here, and that would see him up to third place at the service. Lance Williams pushing on despite his engine losing water and moving into fourth. Hawkswood's engine playing ball now, and he was just 0.2 behind Williams in fifth.
The sick left minus 100.
But Phil Campbell nearly 20 seconds down on Hunt here, just sixth for the day two run, now vulnerable in the overall rally battle. Dylan Turner up to seventh, but a slow start means he's got a lot of work ahead. Featherston going past Ken Block's tree, and Brian Green had spent the previous week on Targa Tasmania, and he put his improved pace down to spending 5 days at speed on tarmac. But Dave Strong's engine woes continued, the Honda-powered S2 Fiesta just getting slower. Hayden Patton continued to push for the rally lead. By the stage end, he was 15 seconds down for the day on Block, but overall, just 1.2 seconds away from Campbell.
Black crest in the back, 7 right, 100, flat 6 right plus, 30, flat 7 left of a crest, 150.
Dean Buist, 8th overall for the day. Marcus Van Klink had repaired his brake issue, but still not producing the stage times. He was 12th after the opening stages.
Two right here, injunction. Oh, fuck. Fuck, mate. Come on. Told you. 5 left, 100, and narrow 5 right. Coming up narrow 5 right. Into a narrow 5 right minus, into a 3 left. Coming up narrow, and then 3 left straight after. 30 into 2 right. 3.
Yep. Oh, shit, the fucking... Something wrong with that.
Ryan Stokes, lucky to only have light damage after his roll, back in the rally about 15 seconds behind Van Klink for the day. And Tony Gosling out on the stage with a damaged engine. So after two stages, Ken Block leads day two, Hayden Patton into second, and a good battle between the next four, just 5.7 seconds separating the third to sixth place. First of the Benton Service Parks, Ken Block.
I'm a little off though today just because when you're not battling for a lead, you don't drive the same way. So I had a little off this morning and just a little bit of shrub brush just because I had a note wrong over a crest. And that's just the thing with that one pass recce, and the note's a bit difficult here. I just got one wrong. So driving a little not as good as I would like, but trying to enjoy the stages. The next couple are, you know, a couple of my favorites. So looking forward to getting back out there.
Alex, a few challenges with a new car, but hearing in the forest, it's absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, that's about the only positive, the noise, everybody loves that. This morning I just had like a half spin and then we couldn't restart the engine, so we like stopped, and then we had to find some people to bump start it, and yeah, it was your camera crew actually.
And it's a blast through Waipuri Gorge next as the rally heads for Berwick Forest. Ken Block winning the stage and setting a new record of 7 minutes 49.8. Alex Kelsey, second fastest, 7 minutes 57. And Ben Hunt, slightly slower, 7 minutes 59.
This stage really is one of the classics of Otago Rally. Beautiful stage, everybody loves it.
Keep in 5 left, plus 50.
Stage 13, Berwick, the longest at 41 kilometres. A great challenge to finish the morning stages.
And he's certainly working the brakes there. Listen, these stages, they're used a lot. He won't know them as well as the other competitors.
Plus.
Block's time, 26 minutes 51.9. What can Ben Hunt do?
30, Hope long 5 right, minus over finish. Keep in at 6 left. Keep in 6 left.
He's charging.
Down to the wire then, Hunt, 26 minutes 34, nearly 18 seconds up on Block. Spectacular speed too from Phil Campbell here.
Well, he's got to keep the overall rally in mind for huge points, but that was impressive. And he wants to get as many points as he can get.
Also stepping up, Matt Summerfield, very strong here, just 7.5 behind Block.
Minus.
Lance Williams nursing his Subaru now. The head gasket's holding on, but he had to add water at the start and the finish of the stages. Alex Kelsey finished the stage fifth fastest, showing that the car can survive a long stage. But losing time on the stage, Dylan Turner.
And 4 left, 30. And 5 right plus. Short 5 left and 4 right plus.
But more woes for Andrew Hawkswood.
Oh.
A rock causing a puncture. And then the misfire returned. And he'll be forced to retire at the stage end. Hayden Patton dropping time on this stage. Obviously, the forest not the easiest place to drive a BDA Escort at pace.
Flat 7 right, 80. Long flat 7.
Overall, though, he was now 30 seconds down on Campbell. Van Klink second in class, but still easily leads the points. Andy Martin in third, but the RX3 not very suited to these stages.
Rotaries have always had a lot of power, but low down torque is they struggle with. So he's going to have lots of power, but not much torque driving him off the corners.
So at the Vin Service Park, the day two lead belongs to Block, then Summerfield, Campbell ahead of Patton.
Being first on the road, there's just so much pollution, and at the beginning of the stage, I was trying to learn how much speed I could carry through some of the corners and just pushed it a little too hard and ended up spinning. So it is what it is. That's the penalty of being first on the road sometimes, is I'm the one that gets to do all the sweeping. But the Gorge Road was absolutely beautiful. That's one of my favorite stages in the world. It's absolutely incredible.
That long forestry stage is always going to be crucial to get through there with no problems. Looks like you're doing a little bit of work on the brakes.
Yeah, it's a long stage and it's definitely one of the trickier ones of the rally. We got through there pretty good. It's just the last couple of Ks, the brakes went a little bit spongy. They had a little bit of fluid out, must have a melted seal or something. So the boys will just fix that now and be all good to go for the last three this afternoon.
Dave, a few small problems with this rally, but you are still going.
Yeah, well, that's better than a lot of them. We're still driving as hard as I can, but the car's just basically, it's hopeless. It's probably lost about 20, 30% of its power. So, yeah, we're just boxing on, trying to get some points.
Do you know why that is?
Yeah, I think what actually happened, it was jammed in gear at Whangarei, and as we dragged it onto the trailer, it's jumped a tooth on the cam timing, and that's actually what's happened. It's retarded.
Hey everyone, how you going? Dylan Turner here. LJ Hook Evo 9. Just wanted to show you what our service boys are doing at the moment. As you can see, they've been putting wheels and tyres on pretty quickly, pretty madly. We did a wheel alignment. That's what these little paddles are for down here. You can see those. So it was all good. It was all fine. We had a bit of a crap stage, the last stage. As you can see, I did this to a tyre. And it was a bit of a shame. We lost about a minute and a half, but never mind. That is rallying. And if you just run around the front here pretty quickly. This is Ian, he's my panel beater. He's the best guy in the world. We've got a little chip in the windscreen. Now I'm heading back out to the stages, so looking forward to the afternoon's rally. See you later.
Thanks, Dylan. Yes, three stages to go, starting with Table Hill. Ken Block, the first to experience this new stage at the back of the Milton Township.
So that was pretty cool, wasn't it? Ken Block, full on sideways. Nice, fast public road, plenty of crest, get into it stuff.
At times, the stage is wide open, perfect for Ben Hunt.
Ben's well known for being extremely quick in the tight stuff, but he's also showing he's going really well in this fast stuff. High commitment and a lot more power.
Long six left, 150. Keep in a six left minus 300. Keep in a six left minus 300. Flat long seven right, 150.
Alex Kelsey had rejoined again and posted second fastest, 6.4 behind Block. But Matt Summerfield still very much in the hunt here. He was now second for the day, and with Block not eligible for points, he looks set to get 7 points at least for the day. Phil Campbell only sixth fastest on the stage. If he could stay ahead of Patton though, there was still a chance of the outright rally win and maybe the championship lead. Also looking at the overall rally standings, Lance Williams keeping his engine alive and holding on to third overall. Dylan Turner fourth overall but eighth in the day two standings behind the escort of Dean Buist. And taking the bumpy road, Brian Green stepping up the pace.
He's been really impressive this weekend. We're out watching him in the stages and every single time it was the best I've seen him drive.
Flat three right plus opens very long nips. Flip, go three left plus. Seven right, 30.
Patton after the overall rally win. 1986 was the last time a two-wheel drive car won a round of the New Zealand Rally Championship. Neil Lawport in his RX-7. Patton, 30 seconds out of the start of the stage, finishes just 17.1 seconds down on Campbell. So in the day two standings, Ken Block still leads by 54 seconds to Matt Summerfield, then Phil Campbell and Hayden Patton. Before we go to the power stage, a chance to analyse three generations of cars at our favourite spectator spot.
Just look at the suspension travel, tyres on the ground, even though the road dropped away, plenty of grip. Look at the shock, not quite in control, tyre off the ground, but it's rear wheel drive. And Ben, not quite as much shock travel, he's taken a wider line because he can't afford to take such a big cut. Still plenty of traction though.
Currie Bush has been described as a bit of Finland in New Zealand. Certainly a fitting end to this rally.
And Block's quite tentative over these crests. It's a very well-known road for the Kiwi guys. They'll be a lot more committed, and the time should show that. In saying that, he's still going to really enjoy this road. How good is it to see a World Rally car on this road?
7:58.9 for Block.
That stage right there is actually one of the most difficult ones. Just
so many difficult turns over crests that you have to get right in the notes. And yeah, I struggled on recce, but it still ended up being an incredible stage and a lot of fun.
Ben Hunt next through. He'll be looking for maximum points to keep his championship lead.
He was starting to run out of tyres though, so whether he's got enough tyre for the stage, we'll have to see.
Keep in long 5 left, opens 200.
Remember Ken Block's time, 7:58.9. His time going to be faster, 7:46.
Mate, that's one of my favourite stages in New Zealand. It's got a bit of everything in it, tight corners, fast, big crest, and yeah, it's just full commitment the whole time. Pretty unlucky we ran out of tyres at the end of today, so been running pretty bald tyres for the afternoon, but it's good fun. I don't know if it's going to be the fastest, sir.
Just 7.8 seconds separating Campbell and Patton going into the stage.
It's a little bit tricky for Phil. He won't know the gap. He's on the road a lot earlier than Hayden, so he's a little bit driving blind time-wise. He'll be focused on getting to the end, getting a clean stage, and maximising his points haul for the weekend.
30.
Oh, well done. You did good.
Yeah, we made it.
Yeah. That's good.
Well, it's down to the line, and his time, 8:03.1. Will that be enough?
We probably weren't as fast as what we could have been for the power stage points, but with this weekend, it was just about getting to the end and keeping our position we had last night, so yeah, we're stoked with it.
A sensible drive by Lance Williams, so he finished the day in fifth, but would be on the podium for the overall rally and seemed his engine had finally held on. Dylan Turner, 8:04, so just enough to keep him ahead of Hunt for the weekend.
No third gear, and we're here, and we just managed to hold out Ben, I believe, so we're over the moon, over the moon. Woohoo!
Matt Summerfield had fought hard all day, looked set to take the points for day two. Now, could he add the power stage?
And just look at the commitment over that crest. Matt's been building over the last years, building with speed, and this weekend, a real turning point. The speed on these stages is fantastic.
Down to the line is time, 7:39.3, fastest through the power stage.
First quickest in the power stage, what a magic time.
Yeah, it's pushing pretty hard in there, eh? Really went super wide early on, and Nicole gave me a telling off, but I already knew that I'd made a mistake, so.
So just Hayden Patton left to run. He needs a time of 7:55.3 to take the rally win. Let's buckle up and go for a ride.
Plus K right.
Well, this is it. Down to the line.
35 right.
7:52.7. He's done it.
7:52.
I think we're friggin' 40.
When we saw the time with three to go, we all knew it was game on. It's just been fantastic watching the stage times come through. What an exciting event.
Yeah, it's just been a huge amount of fun. Lots of sideways. We've had lots of laughs in the car, and you know, whenever the stages are a bit faster and a bit more downhill, you know, the two-wheel drive's not so disadvantaged. And, you know, as I say, Phil put us under pressure. We had to push in these last two, and it paid off.
So the final rally result, then Hayden Patton wins by 2.5 seconds to Phil Campbell. Lance Williams third, Ben Hunt fifth, and that's enough to keep the championship lead. A double podium for Patton, also winning the classic rally from Alistair McRae and Marcus Van Klink. So Ben Hunt, 66 points. Campbell, 59, and Summerfield still in touch on 43. Van Klink, 8th outright, but leads the historic class. Next up, Canterbury Rally, May 30th. See you then.